sad little bunny down here with a Superman cape on. But it looks like he's going to get better, because it appears that if you get hold of these little things, good things happen to you. I usually just start pulling canvases and I'll just make chaos on the canvas. I have no idea what I'm going to paint when I start. I have absolutely no idea. Actually, I try not to think about what I'm doing. I try and get myself out of the way so the art can make itself, which I didn't make up that phrase. I usually will listen to podcasts. I'm kind of a podcast junkie. And I listen to music, and I try to focus on what I'm listening to and not what I'm doing. So I grab the paints and I mix things just based on feeling more than really thinking it through. I try not to think about it so that it is spontaneous. You've got all this line and texture and form and color, and really I'm just reacting to the way the paint moves and the things it bumps up against, the other shapes that are or line or color that's on the canvas or texture. So I'm just kind of spontaneously reacting as I paint until maybe a lyrics from a song or something I heard in a podcast comes into my head while I'm looking at something, and then I'll write that on the index card and then I'll just keep painting. Eventually, when I'm done, I can look back through all the index cards and I know exactly what the piece is about, and the title of the piece is on one of those index cards. I like oil paint. I do use a lot of water-based oil paints, and the reason I do that is because sometimes the brushes hit the floor and I start painting with my hands. I'll use sculptural stuff, wire, epoxy, leather. I'll use canvas. I love to rip up one canvas from one painting and mount it onto another painting. Sometimes I'll use paper onto a canvas and do a mixed media thing. And I like to paint on stretched canvas, but I'll paint on a guitar occasionally, or a mandolin, or, hey, here's that banjo head that my husband gave me off his banjo, and the next thing you know it's on the canvas, and then there's sculpting compound on the canvas and on the banjo head, and it's part of the piece. The title of the media winner piece is Between History and Progress in Lower Town. I had done several paintings dealing with the way Lower Town has changed in the 14 years that I've been in this studio. I actually studied photography in college, but for the most part, I'm a painter. I do a lot of sculpture. I build the occasional giant puppet. I love photography, but it's not typically the best way for me to express myself. But that shot was so perfect, I had to take it. So I spent all day waiting and getting the light just right. And I took a lot of shots and then weeded through them all and kind of looked over and looked out my studio window, and I thought, look, there's a perfect example of how it's changed. There's this building, this old brick building that's got writing on it about horse harnesses that they're selling and stuff, and then right next to it is this brand new apartment, upscale apartment building, and they're just right next to each other, right in the view of the same window. And I looked down and I had a painting to the left that was of a historic building that I had done, and I had a painting to the right that was really contemporary, and I thought, there it is. There it is. It's all about the being stuck between the old and the new in Lower Town, and trying to find a place for yourself as an artist as things change and not get lost in the transition. I'm so happy when I'm in my studio doing my thing. I can't do anything but paint with bright colors. I do have, occasionally, I have paintings that that aren't happy, but 99.9% of the time when I'm in here, I'm jumping around, I'm dancing, I'm very, very happy. I love being an artist. When people look at my work, probably the most common thing I hear is, it makes me so happy to look at your work. So I think maybe by pouring all of my joy into it, maybe some of the fairy dust goes on to people when they look at the work or something, I don't know. So this piece is called The Least of These, and I do paint a lot of pieces that have themes from the New Testament. There's a lot in the New Testament about taking care of the poor, about loving your neighbor, about community, about love and getting along and taking care of each other. And so sometimes I feel like my work does speak a lot to more conservative people, but also to people on the more progressive end of things. And really, if we're all trying to do these things and get together in community and be kind to one another, we've got to figure out how to meet in the middle. And so sometimes I'm hoping that my artwork will help bridge that gap. Hi, my name is Deanne Parks, and I look forward to seeing you at the St. Paul Art Crawl in April. I'm in Jack's Building, Studio 306. My feeling is that everybody should be creating something. They really should. I don't care if you're building birdhouses or painting on a canvas, and nobody has to see it, but it brings you so much joy to express yourself. Everybody needs to be doing something. Pick up a drum, play music, get involved in community theater, do something, and don't be afraid of other people judging it, because that's what keeps people from being creative. So just find what you're passionate about, what you love, and do it.